Welcome to Grafana 11 for the developers. In this video, we'll deep dive into all of the new features which are important for those who just have an itch to extend Grafana's capabilities even further. Grafana users and operators, do not panic. There are dedicated videos for you as well. Let's jump straight into one of the most exciting new features, plugging scaffolding. We wanted to reduce the friction in setting up your development environment ready to build plugins for Grafana. Entire plugins can now be scaffolded with just one command. Let's jump into VS Code and see how this can be done. The scaffolding feature can be called using the following package managers: npm, pnmp, and yarn. In this example, I'm just going to use npm. To start, we run the command npx at grafana slash create dash plugin at latest. Now we can start running through the scaffolding form. You start with a name, organization, and description. Now we can choose the type of plugin that we would like to scaffold. This could be app, data source, panel, or scenes app. We're going to go with a scenes app. You can also choose whether an app has a backend. In our instance, we're going to be making use of another data source, so we're going to select no. And finally, you can have continuous integration and release workflows included if you like. After filling out this form, this will create a fully scaffolding plugin, including a source, app config, pages, and a Docker compose file. We'll get to this in a moment. Next, we'll run through the post-scaffolding commands. First, you need to cd into the directory that's your new plugin, run npm install, then we can install the end-to-end test dependencies. We can then run and build our front end to look at the code and see it's running correctly. And finally, we can do a Docker compose up in a separate terminal to create a test Grafana server so we can see our new app running. We hope this feature will help to standardize the way our community builds apps for Grafana, as well as greasing the wheels for new developers to start extending Grafana. The Saga Design System hasn't been specifically released for Grafana 11, but deserves an honorable mention since it continues to be updated and improved. The Saga Design System's goal is building a well-organized set of design elements, patterns, and guidelines that ensure visual and functional consistency across all of our products. It is a guiding resource to equipping Grafanistas and our community with pre-established components and principles for crafting visually appealing and easy-to-use interfaces. Let's quickly jump into Saga Design and take a look. I can access Saga Design via grafana.com/developers. From there, I can see a roadmap for future iterations to Saga, as well as to start to navigate different design principles and components. Let's suppose I want to learn about adding an input. I can select input found within components. From this page, I can see a working example, implementation and option guidelines, as well as a working sandbox. And that's it for our Grafana developers walkthrough. There are plenty more features for you to discover, such as scenes-powered visualizations and decoupled plugin access to services such as navigation, search, and RBAC. We hope these features will help to improve your experience as you expand the capabilities of Grafana. Make sure you check out our Grafana 11 videos for the operators and users for more great features in Grafana 11. Once again, a massive thank you to our Grafanista developers and our community for making Grafana 11 possible.